Thank you for joining this workshop, SIA Creative Camp Augmented Reality. So now my name is Purnomo from SIMIO Secretariat Bangkok. Actually, it is a collaboration with SIMIO Simulac Indonesia and SIMIO Geotrop Indonesia. Now here we have Mr. Aji from SIMIO Simulac will explain about STEM project and AR for school. Okay. So before we start this orientation, I will explain about the APEX video conference code of conduct. So the first one is participant can begin to join the video conference 30 minutes prior for audio testing. And the next one is participant are required to disable or mute the microphone when entering the room and during the presentation session. And the next one is during presentation session, please do not make noise. Please pay attention to the presenter. And in the question answering session, participant will be given the opportunity asked by write your name in the chat box. The host may kick the participant from the video conference room if the participant does not follow the code of conduct. So this is the video conference rules for all session. Please log in with this format to join the WebEx. The first one is please mention your school name, and the next one is your name. If you log in with your team, you can use this format: school name underscore team number one, team two, and team three. This is for the example ABC school, terus and then my name, or ABC school, my name, and then your team member name. And please use only one computer to log in into the WebEx system and computer in the projector if it possible. We suggest to all students to be in one room so the student will clearly see the presentation on a big screen. So it is about the workshop. If the student cannot join the WebEx meeting on schedule, students can view preview lecture from the video recording in the SIA Creative Camp website. This is our website for all the session. You can always check this link, this website. And the next one is we will not count the absenteeism. To get the certificate, team must be able to develop a augmented reality project as their final assignment. It is the total participant as 29 January 2018. The amount of the participant is 912 participants from Thailand. We have 12 participants, Philippines 95, Malaysia 43, and Indonesia 758. And we have teams from outside Southeast Asia, from India, four teams, four participants. For the training schedule, you can check in this website creativecamp.simio.org/schedule. So for the AR online workshop, every Monday and Thursday from 1st February 2018 to 26th January 2018, every 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. GMT plus 7.
Sorry. Can you go back to the previous slide? It's about the date.
Okay, it is our training process. It is
is it from 1st of February until the 26th of January? Are you sure?
Oh, okay. We will have question and answering session after this presentation. Okay. Okay, it is our training process. The first process is we will learn to design 3D model using Blender. Is it a free software? And the next one, we will guide you to design a storybook. It is seems like our previous training. We will use storybook as a marker for the ER. And the next one is we will learn about develop ER project using Unity. And the last one is develop application to Android. Okay, for the required requirement is here, it is the minimum requirement for the ER. For the computer or laptop, we use Microsoft Windows 7, 8 or 10 with 32 or 64 bit with minimum 4 GB RAM or 8 GB RAM is recommended with 16 GB of available disk space minimum 32 GB recommended. Here we have we use Android because we use Android because we will use Vuforia. It's like for ER engine. The minimum requirement for the Vuforia is 5.0 Lollipop. So we recommended to use this minimum requirement. It is for the training on the iPhone. For the training material, we use Blender. You can download in here. So the next, our next session, we will start to learn Blender. I hope before our next session, you already download Blender and install it in your computer or personal computer or notebook. The next one is Unity. You can download in on this link. The next one is Vuforia. It is for Unity extension. And the next one is Android SDK. It is to deploy our Unity project to Android. And the next one is Java GRE. Actually, when we install the Android SDK, it needs Java GRE to run this application, Android SDK. You can download in this link or this link. Okay, the next one is we have Telegram group chat. You can join our Telegram group. We will always update every information in this group about training schedule on and the other materials. And please note, we have rules for the group Telegram group chat. The first one is the participant come from countries across Southeast Asia and beyond. We will use English as the communication language. Please use group chat to discuss issues related to the workshop only. Please use your private or personal chat to discuss your personal issues between members. Please avoid to discuss issues unrelated with the workshop activities. Please avoid to share files, pictures, stickers, videos unrelated to the workshop activities. Admin teams have to write to kick or expel those who could not follow the rules. You can share anything and chat to your team in our group, but please note all about these rules. Okay. This is our previous program about augmented reality, the real world of immersive augmented reality. You can watch all the session in here, mooc.simulac.org. And before you see this MOOC, please register if you don't have MOOC account, and you can find this course number CAR01. Okay, it is the for the prize for the winner of this competition. We have competition in the end of this training, so for student and teacher. For the first winner is 7 million rupiah per team, and the second prize is 6 million rupiah per team, and the third winner is 5 million rupiah per team. So the first, second, and third winner will be invited in LKS in Makassar. You can get more information in this link, creativecamp.simu.org. This TVI Ministry of Education and Culture is pleased to support the following expenses to all local and international participants which are the winner of its online workshop. The first is no registration fee to participate in event, accommodation of 4 nights, lunch, coffee break, and dinner, and monetary prizes for the winner of 5 online training program and competition. Please note the airfare ticket of the participant should be supported by the student, parents, or college. Okay, the next one is we have Mr. Aji from Simio Simolek will explain about AR STEM and for AR for school program. Question and sharing session after this presentation. Please always mute your audio.
I see. Yes, hello. Can you hear me? Hello.
Oh, not yet. We have another presentation from Mr. Aji. Okay, Mr. Aji.
Yes, yes.
Okay, you can.
Yeah. Mas, pada edisi pertama, Mas. Okay, wait for a second. I'm gonna set in my audio here. So I hope everyone can hear me clear. I have a little noise. Okay. Let me introduce myself. My name is Aji, like in alphabetic A, J, and I. And I come from Simeo Simolek, Jakarta, Indonesia. And actually, this is not me that, not I'm alone that being charged for AR and VR. So there's one person or two persons beside me. There's called Alvan and Haritz. Anyway, I will tell you about augmented reality. Let me share my screen first.
Oi. Kami ngomongan ini jam apa tuh?
Oh, di luar saya, di mic saya. Ngomongan ini.
Suara
Sanset
kid kok lagi Mas udah mulai Mas udah beli.
Halo, halo.
Yes, hello. How about now? Test. Okay. So, here we have two projects called AR STEM project and one more is school project. Would you mind to mute your microphone for just a couple of minutes, please? So I got feedback here. Yes, so... Okay. So, anyway, well, if there's an among of you doesn't know about... Okay,
of digital information with the user environment.
time, like we can attach some 3D object in top
markers and make it come to the real life, but we have to see it through, of course, a digital device like mobile, tablet, some kind of device. So we are moving to the STEM, and actually STEM stands for science, technical, engineering, and mathematics. So connecting with,
can you make your speaker, your microphone louder?
Oh yes, I'm sorry, I already speak loud. Okay, how about now?
Semang kencang-kencang nih fitnya. Oi. Dia sudah kan.
So. Jatuh.
Test. Hello. How about now? No, not yet.
It's okay.
Hey, oh, it's already on. Hey, thank you, thank you. I got some audio problem right here. It's okay. Let me back it to my slide, and I will present it from the start again because I made a mistake about the audio system. Okay, I'm gonna share my presentation. Yes, okay. So we have two projects called AR STEM project and school project, and so of it, of course, should be made using an AR technology, of course. So what is augmented reality anyway? So like you have already known, we already in this rapid development of technology. So augmented reality is like interpretation of digital information with the user's environment in real time. So if you given like some data about like animation, graphic, and sound maybe, or video, you can embed in some mark. Yes, we got mark, and you can embed all this 3D things, animation or video, on top, in top those marks, so you can see it through the digital device like tablets, mobile phone, etc. So like to integrate those technology with STEM. Actually STEM is come from science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. So would like to make an AR application that built with this in maybe you have an interest in science maybe or technology and then engineering whatever engineering it is and mathematics. Yes. So lately in South Asia, it's been so popular here. We discuss a lot about this STEM education. So we're moving into the first project about AR STEM project. So about AR STEM project is conduct thing with four persons. So one person is teacher and the three persons are the students. So you have to make a one group that consists of one teacher and three students. They'll make an application about, of course, AR that explain about science, technology, engineering, and mathematics, of course. And then the last one is AR school project. So this is a large scale from the last AR STEM project. So the idea is, our idea is to implement the AR application throughout the school, everywhere. I mean in your school. So every you in here study in school, right? So we want to AR is implemented in your school, in wherever location it is. It could be library or class or outside class, or it could be field or wherever it's possible to give an AR. So for AR school concept, we have for one school, because it's school project, for each school should have minimal have 5 program study. So if you have 5 program study like mathematics, and then English or language, and then science maybe, and well, etc. So you have to have you still have 5 program studies, and each program studies have to has a one teachers as a person in contact. So this person in contact will act as a leader for each group. So each group is contain one teacher and three students. Yes. Each group is consists of one teacher and three students. So each of group have to be identical to each of its study program. If you want to make an application based on engineering, so it should be engineering, and then the other one should be different. I mean, yes. So the output is actually for one school is just one application, but every each study program should like make the content like the 3D objects. So if you work in the study program of mathematics, so you should have 3D objects for your mathematics, and then your own markers for mathematics, and then the topic itself. The topic itself means if you have an algebra, maybe for the method for explaining to the application. So that's the topic what I mean. So for different example, if you have a topic about language, for example in English, and you want to make an English application that explain about a verb or words, so you have make these topics and then plus the 3D objects inside it or videos, and then the last one is the markers. And then finally, you have to compile all those study program. You have to compile all those study program into one application. So the one who compile this application, there's one person that act as the top leader for compiling this all content from each study program. Well, I think it's confusing, so you can raise your hand and ask after this. That's it, maybe
Mas.
Mr. Pramono, yes. Yes, that's all for me, and okay, if you want us, hello, Mr. Purnomo. Yes, we'll have a sharing session after okay. this, so
yeah, thank you, sure. Mr. Yeah,
yes, to you the write your question. Yes, thank you.
Question, you can write down your question in the chat box and then send to everyone, so you don't need to unmute your audio. Okay, please write down your question in the chat box.
Dan. Mas Aji.
Okay. Please always mute your audio.
Mas Aji.
Your question in the chat box. Okay, there is any question from ENT.office. Can we download the slide of your presentation? Okay. Okay. We will always update every information in here, Creative Camp. Please always check the materials in here, creativecamp.cma.org. You can click the workshop session and then choose multimedia augmented reality. We will always update the materials, include our today session video recording and PowerPoint in here. So please check this link, this website periodically, creativecamp.cma.org/workshop/er. And you can also join our Telegram group by clicking this button. Oh, sorry. Oh, okay. We will always update every information in here, creativecamp.cma.org/workshop. We will put all the materials, include today's presentation and video recording appreciation in here. So please always check this website periodically. So you can also join our Telegram group by clicking this button. And we use same Webex number for all session with same password. If you want to log into Webex, just click this link. Okay, another question. So can I use MacBook to do this project? Okay, actually we use Blender, Unity, Vuforia, and this all this application to develop the AR. If MacBook support all this software, you can use MacBook. But if your MacBook doesn't support this all this app, I think you can use Windows or some or other operating system. You can check if this software can support MacBook or not. You can check in this link. Okay, for example, I check for the Blender whether it support Mac or not. Okay, for the Blender it support Mac.
Mas,
for the Blender, to designing Blender you can use your Mac because it support Mac. For the other software such as Unity, you can check Unity. Oh, it so Unity it support for Mac. I think you can use your Mac to design your 3D Blender and for the Unity. Can we download the slide of your presentation? Yes, we will share our today's presentation and our video today in here. So always check this website. Please send your question to everyone. Don't send to me because Ms. Raji can check your question. I'm sorry, I cannot use Bahasa Indonesia because it's international workshop. So, not just Indonesian join this program. It's from all Southeast country, Southeast Asia country. Yes, you can use your Mac for this project because Mac support for Unity and Blender.
Oh, okay, okay.
Okay, I will paste the Telegram. Oh, for the Unity. For the Unity, I think you can use the other version for the personal, not pro, because I'm not sure the pro version is it free or not. You can use personal version because I use personal version. Okay, Mr. Raji, there is any question from Lorien Lee Abadam. He don't know the process of the project. Can you explain again?
Yes, of course. I would love to explain again because it's like everyone doesn't understand yet what our projects are, so I will do it once more. Anyway, would you mind to make me a presenter? Super young. No.
Yes. Okay. Yes, yes, wait.
I'll wait. Okay, thank you. So, we're gonna move on to our project here. I'm sure I will move into the
project that maybe okay here. So long story short, we have a two projects. First project is AR sim project consisting of 1 teacher and 3 students, and you have to make an AR application with your students, teachers of course. So with implementing science, technology, engineering and mathematics. Yes, I don't see any problem in here. And then next one is about AR school project. This is one I think maybe you don't understand about. So wait a second, let me write in my monitor. So this is the AR school concept. The concept is to actually our idea is to make an application or AR application that could be implemented in some place in inside your school. So maybe it's in library or in your classes, everywhere it's possible in your school. So this is the map concept for the group. So this AR school, like its name is school, is school project. So it have be it should be done in as a school group. So it's school, so I have here it's consisted. This one is one school. And then so for PIC here, so maybe it could be a headmaster. Yes, the one PIC for one could be a headmasters. And then for each school should be have a 5 study programs that competing in the AR school concept. Take an example for each study program here. It could be mathematics. And then wait a second. One here is science maybe.
Why my friends can join?
Then I give to you 3 examples of it. Here is what we have to biology. So it's for 5 study programs should have its identical study programs, and there's a 1 PIC under each group of study program. It consists its own teachers. I mean, if you are making an application about math, so the PIC should be a math teacher, of course, math teacher. Well, I have a bad handwriting here, so please spare me. Anyway, for the science, of course, officially a science teacher.
Please, Mr. Thanks.
Yes. So, etc. And then 3 students is just students that make the content. So each group here should be make a content about each study program. I mean, content is about the here objects or videos. I'm sorry. Good. So each study program should make a content identical to each study program. If it's math, So you have to make an object that explains about math. Yes, it could be a 3D objects or videos, and then it's on markers because we want to make an AR application here. So what is markers? It will be explained in the MOOC.simulac letter, so you don't have to worry, I think. So yes, so after that, if we got here science, so you have to make an object and videos about science. If there's biology, so you have to make a content about biology. So after all that content that you made is done, you can compile those content. Yes, compile. So the one who compile is actually, you can discuss it with your group or your headmaster. So who the ones that compile this all content from each 2D program? I have thinking that the one who have to compile is someone that have related to IT, or someone that strong in technology, or maybe some kind like that. Yes, that's all about AR school project and things. That's all. Is there any more question or still you don't understand about?
Thank you, Mr. Aji.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. We will try to reply them question one by one. Okay. Please send your question to everyone. Don't send question to me. So I mean. Okay. Okay, wait. Okay, for the link download, we will share my presentation and Mr. Aji's presentation in here, in creativecamp.cme.org, and then you can download our presentation, and then you can download the Blender, Unity, all training materials after you download our presentation. Okay. And does it mean we're gonna make around 15 teams? Okay, I will explain to you about for the ER STEM project and for the school project. Actually, for the STEM project, it consists of one team. One team is consists of one teacher and three students, same like our previous training. And the team is STEM, science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. So why STEM? Because in your ER, you have to explain about your problem in your cities. For example, it is a traffic jam in Malang. So the traffic makes a problem, that is carbon monoxide from the car engine. So the effect is from this problem is a pollution effect for the healthy life. And then the solution is, what is solution of from this problem to solve the traffic jam and to solve the carbon monoxide from the car engine? So here I have the solution for this problem is the people is use bicycle to go to work or go to school. So I think can solve the problem for the traffic jam and for the healthy life. It is an example for the STEM project. So we solve this problem is from science. So So you can choose science and technology, or technology and engineering, or mathematics and engineering. So here I just give you example about this problem from science. You can find other problem from your city to make your AR. So in your AR application, you make a story about main problem in your city. Okay, it is the problem solving with STEM. So the teams who registered in STEM project, so your team should be consist of one teacher and three students. So in your, sorry, please always mute your audio. So in this STEM, you have to select one of main problem in your city. For the example, this from Malang City. It is the top traffic jam in Malang. So what is the problem from this? What is the effect from this problem? Is the carbon monoxide from car engine? So effect from this problem is healthy life for the people. So like asthma, start and diabetes and lung cancer and etc. And then what is the solution from this problem? So here I give solution is people can use bicycle to go to work or go to school. So from this solution, it can solve traffic jam and healthy life. From the bicycle, people can be more healthy. Something like that, because I hope in your ER you can explain step by step about the STEM. So you solve the problem with STEM. It is example from science. So you can mix from science with technology, or technology with mathematics, or engineering with science. At least two subjects, science and mathematics, or etc. Okay. For the STEM project, you have to develop at least 5 pages. That's one page is one 3D model. So when you point your camera to the image target, the 3D model will be appear. Marker is mean is like image target. If you point your camera to the picture, okay, I will show you the sample of the ER. What is ER? It is a final assignment from the first batch. It is the image target. It is the image target. If the camera detect the image target, the 3D model will be shown in your camera. It is the image target. So in AR STEM project, you have to develop at least 5 image target, and that means 5 pics. Okay, question for Muhammad Basir. AR STEM and AR study project for school is same thing or not? It's different because AR STEM is consists of one teacher and three students, and for the AR study project is it's like representing your school. It's project from all your school. From your every study program, so every program study have to develop at least 5 3D models and then send the 3D model to the PIC of the school, and then he or she can compile the AR application. Okay, please send your question to everyone. Oh, it's so many questions. Mr. Haji.
Hey, yes, I'm here.
Can you help me to answer the?
Oh, of course. Yes. Which question that you want to answer?
So many questions.
Which one? Okay.
Oh, sorry.
Not the same. Yes, that's one thing. Then okay, welcome our friends from Priotrop, Mr. Haritz and Miss Rihanna, yes. Welcome to our back. I'm sorry, I couldn't see the participants. What question that you have for me? Okay, wait a second. I will look at the question. So, I think that many of you still doesn't understand about what the marker means, and then the content. It is too technical, I think. What would that? All I already explained later. So, speak louder so I can hear you. Okay. One topic is
Yeah, so for AR school output, to make it short, you have to make one application. One application consists of five groups or teams. So five teams make a five topic, and then it have its own PIC, then it creates one final AR application. Yes. Expound? Why? Wait a second. I have a lot of question here. Wait a second. What would you choose? Do you need to submit only one project? So. Okay. AR STEM. So I got question from. Okay, about AR STEM project, so you have one group consists of one teacher and three students making an application that taken from either from one from science, technology, engineering, or mathematics. So the choice is up to yours. So which one that you want to make for your application is, so you don't have to make from all those STEM. So I mean you just have to choose one from.
Please help me. Yes.
Okay. Explain. Okay, 3D object and another thing will be explained at another meeting. I get a question from Muhammad Basif Al-Kifuri. Yes, it will be explained at another meeting. Actually, we have a course that explain about an AR at moc.simulac.org. So make sure you register to that site. Why would you just? Okay. So I'm sorry, I can't speak Indonesian, but we are not allowed here because it's South Asian here. Okay, yes, you don't have to make a five, what? That's cool. So, okay, I got a question from Semka Penrisen. So we need.
Mr. Aji.
Yes.
Yeah, can I take the presenter?
Just a moment. Okay. You can take it, but yes, okay. Of course. Take.
Okay. Okay, for the question for STEM project, actually you can check it in the moc.simulac.org. can find a course. After you log in, here I already log in. I have account, MOC account, and then you can find.
Thank you, sir.
Yes.
Thank you.
And then you can click here, the real world of immersive augmented reality. Actually, it's same with the STEM project, but the difference is the theme. In here, in this course is with the same process. Actually, the difference is just theme for the AR theme. In this workshop, the theme is STEM, science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. You have to show what is STEM in your ER project. You can see the courseware in this website MOC, and here actually it's same with our workshop. Now you can learn stuff from here, from moc.simulac.org. but in every page is your storybook. It is the ER. What is ER? Here we will learn how to make a storybook. What it is the storybook? It's just a for marker, as a marker. It's same like this. If this camera is point to this picture, this specific picture, the 3D model will be appear on your gadget or tablet or phone, something like that. But in here, it's like the theme is. About the structure, right? The Eiffel, Liberty, the Pisa, Big Ben, something like that. But in this workshop, you have to develop your ER based STEM project. STEM is like science, engineering, mathematics, and technology. From the STEM, you can take what is the problem in your city. Your city is like. For the example, this is the traffic jam in Malang City. For the example, I take this problem, and what is makes this problem is carbon monoxide for the car engine. And then what is effect from this problem is makes healthy. It's not good. For the example is for cognition. Type of diabetes and lung cancer, and what is the solution from this problem? Is the for me the solution is cycling. So cycling is can solve the traffic jam and can solve this healthy problem. So, okay. So in your AR storybook, you can explain page by page. For the example, for the first page, what is the problem in your city? For the first page, you can explain about what is your problem, the problem traffic jam. And then the second page, it's what is a problem from science in this problem. The from science is carbon monoxide from car engine is not good for health, right? And the third page, you can explain what is the healthy effect from this problem. The effect is older person, for the older person is poor cognition, lung cancer, and etc. And for the child, it is all the problem from this problem. Okay. And the fourth page, you can show the solution from this all this problem. That is. Using bicycle for go to work or go to school. By using bicycle, people can solve the traffic jam problem and can make the people more healthy. Something like that. Okay, any more question? I will check the checkbox. Okay, the Telegram group, you can check in here. Miss or Miss Ting. Ting. You can check in here. creativecamp.cimeo.org/workshop/er, and then you can click here, join our Telegram group. But before you click this link, you have to log in into Telegram, okay, and then click join group, just like that. Not all final project is STEM. It's STEM project is just for wait. So actually here we have two types of VR. The first one is STEM project, and the second one is AR for school. For the STEM, the theme is just STEM, only STEM. And for the AR for school, the theme is depend program study in your school. It's okay. Okay, to download all these apps, I will upload my PowerPoint file in here in workbook here, creativecamp.cimeo.org/workshop/er, and then you can find the material, my PowerPoint and Mr. Rajis PowerPoint in here, and then you can download the PowerPoint, and then you can download it. Here, I already gave the link. You can download one by one. It's okay. Okay. For the deadline, you can check the schedule. It is our schedule. Okay. For the deadline is after the training session. It is our last training session. You have time for develop your ER. This is assignment period, and then I think it is the deadline for the project, first marks, and then you have evaluation by judging committee. It is the presentation, and we will announce the winner announcement. You can check in our website creativecamp.cimeo.org. For the winner, we just have first, second, and third winner. Only three, just three. For the apps, because our next session is Blender. Our next session is Blender. You install Blender. Because our next session is start to learn Blender. I hope you install Blender before our next session. Yes, for the STEM actually to solve the problem in your city, the main problem. How you can solve the problem with science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. For the topic, I think you choose two, science and technology, or science and engineering, not just one. You can mix science and technology, or science and mathematics, or mathematics with technology, technology with engineering, something like that. It is the example from the science. Okay, Mr. Rashi. Yeah. Hello.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you. You're still here.
Yeah, I'm still here. And actually, there is one person. There's Haritz, or maybe he could maybe help us to explain.
Oh yeah.
Yes, of course.
Yeah, Mr. Haritz. Yeah, I will keep you to the presenter. Okay. Thank you, Mr. Haritz. Hello, Mr. Haritz.
Yo.
Lines better. Okay, for the question from SMA 1 Bengkulu, I would like ask about our present, is it important? And I think you can see the video recording appreciation in here. If you not cannot present, you can see the video recording in here. Please send your question to everyone. Mr. Raji?
Yes, bro.
Any question from...
Yes, there's question from... okay, from SMPN 5 Team 1. Can we use a basic topic just like the problem of global warming? Yes, I think it's not a problem. Yes, you can use a global warming. Then got question from Muhammad Ferry Portana. So we can mix all of them in one final project? Yes, the content that you mean. Yes, yes it is. You can mix all of them.
Okay, for the spec PC. For the spec PC, it's Microsoft Windows, or you can also using Linux with minimum 4 GB RAM. And for the Android, it's minimum Lollipop with Android version 5.0. Okay, please send your question to everyone. Hello, Mr. Raji. Another question, what is marker?
Yes, I don't have room to explain about marker, but are you sure we have to explain that in here and right now? Because we have a course for AR, right? So I don't mind if I have to explain it for now. Essentially, marker. If you're wondering about the marker, if you have ever seen a percut
that's a marker. So that's to make a shard of marker. Yes, that's the perker. So if you want to make an AR application, you have to make one perker for each object. Yes, that's a marker. If you ever seen a perker, that's marker. So a marker can be made by another than barcode. You can use an image or anything that come in image. It could be called a marker. So the conclusion is, if you ever see a barcode, then that is a marker. If you're wondering how marker works, just follow our course in moc.simulac.org that Mr. Purnomo already said later. Yes, that's it.
Okay. I think there is too many questions. If you have other questions, you can ask your question in our Telegram group. I think that is just today. It's just orientation about STEM project and school project. So if you have other question, you can chat in our Telegram group. Okay, is that is enough? You can ask other question in Telegram group. Okay, to Mr. Aji.
Yes.
Maybe you later you can send your PowerPoint to me. Yeah,
I will post
it on our website. Okay. If you have other question, you can ask your question in Telegram group. And our next session is on Monday next week, 5th February 2018, with the same time, 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. with the same WebEx room and password. We will, our topic next is basic Blender. We will start to learn how to basic Blender. If you want to explore about Blender, you can find in moc.simio.org. You can see this course, all this course, basic Blender, advanced Blender, and anything. Okay. So it is our next session on Monday. You can check in here. So make sure before our next session, you can install the Blender. You can download in here. You can check your laptop or computer operating system. You can click in here and then you can download it. If you're using Windows, you can click in here. And see you in the next session. I hope you already installed it. Okay, see you. Thank you to Mr. Aji. Thank you so much. And also Mr. Harif, and see you in the next session.
Don't forget about Miss Rihanna. She's here too.
Thank you guys. Goodbye.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Yo, thank you.
Okay, okay.
You're welcome.
Thank you, sir, for that.
Thank you, and see you the next meeting.